Hello dear learners, welcome to the massive open online course for class 12th in chemistry on Swayam. Dear learners, chemistry is the study of matter and its properties. How and why substances combine or separate to form other substances, how substances interact to absorb or produce energy. Chemistry is a physical science and it is the study of the properties of and interactions between matter and energy. The state of matter in which materials are not fluid but retain their boundaries without support, the atoms or molecules occupying fixed positions with respect to each other and unable to move freely is a solid state. Solid state chemistry, also sometimes referred to as materials chemistry, it is the study of the synthesis, structure and properties of solid phase materials, particularly but not necessarily exclusively of non-molecular solids. Solid state inorganic chemistry has been strongly driven by technology. Progress in the field has often been fueled by the demands of industry, well ahead of purely academic curiosity. In chemistry, a solution is a homogeneous mixture composed of two or more substances. In such a mixture, a solute is a substance dissolved in another substance, known as a solvent. In day-to-day life, we rarely come across pure substances, so it is important to know the composition of these mixtures. For example, particular concentrations of certain elements within permissible limits in drinking water are essential, while higher concentrations may be poisonous. The P block elements, as classified in the periodic table, are unified by the fact that the valence electrons of these elements are in the P orbital, except helium. The properties of P block elements, like that of others, are greatly influenced by atomic sizes, ionization enthalpy, electron gain enthalpy, and electronegativity. The absence of inner d orbitals in second period and presence of inner d or inner d and f orbitals in heavier elements, which start from the third period onwards, have significant effect on the properties of elements. In addition, the presence of all the three types of elements, namely metals, metalloids, and nonmetals in the p block, brings diversification in the chemistry of these elements. Oxidation reduction reactions involve energy changes and are based on electron transfer. Therefore, the net release or absorption of energy occurs in the form of electrical energy rather than as heat. These reactions are less polluting, therefore, are very important for creating new technologies. The branch of chemistry that deals with electricity related applications of redox reactions is called electrochemistry. The sensory signals that travel to and fro between the brain and the cells of our body are electrochemical in origin. Electrochemistry, therefore, is a vast interdisciplinary subject. The study of reaction rates is called chemical kinetics, and it could provide valuable information on conversion of an explosive reaction into a slow reaction and thus convert harmful explosion into a useful reaction for producing energy for the betterment of mankind. It also helps in the prediction of the feasibility of a reaction to occur to determine the rate of a reaction. Chemical kinetics not only helps us to determine the speed or rate of a reaction, but also describes the condition by which the reaction rates can be altered. Surface chemistry deals with the surface phenomenon of interfaces. Many important phenomena such as corrosion, electrode processes, heterogeneous catalysis, dissolution, and crystallization occur at the interfaces. Surface chemistry has many applications in industry, analytical work, and daily life situations. In the unit of surface chemistry, you would be studying about some of the important features like adsorption, catalysis, colloids, emulsions, gels, etc. A few elements like carbon, sulfur, gold, and noble gases occur in free state while others in the combined form in the Earth's crust. Out of many minerals in which a metal may be found, only a few are viable to be used as source of these metals. Such minerals are known as ores. The extraction and isolation of an element from its combined form involves various principles of chemistry. However, some general principles are common to all the extraction processes of metals. The process of metallurgy and isolation should be such that it is chemically feasible and commercially viable. The chapter General Principles and Processes of Isolation Elements deals with the scientific and technological processes used for isolation of the metal from its ores. Many compounds of transition metals have peculiar empirical formulas and are often bright in color. These are coordination compounds. The major distinguishing feature is that these are huge compounds with a central metal atom surrounding by 2 to 6 or more chemical groups arranged in a proper geometry. With the intention of putting forth a course which is not only interactive and systematic but also great fun to learn, my dear learners, we welcome you most warmly to the course. The course will deal with solid state, solutions, p-block elements, electrochemistry, chemical kinetics, surface chemistry, general principles and processes of isolation of elements, and coordination chemistry from grade 12th chemistry syllabus. This course is intended for the students of class 12th, semester 3 specifically, and also for others interested in brushing up their knowledge in chemistry in general. These chapters are divided into modules as per syllabus. Each module will be having e-content, video tutorial, self-assessment questions, and additional links or web links of study material related to the topics. This is a 6-month course. Each week, one or more modules prepared following the 4-quadrant approach will be offered to the learners, with the intention to put forth a course which is not only interactive and systematic, but also great fun to learn. My dear learners, we welcome you most warmly to the course. Professor Alka Mehrotra, Professor Anjani Kaul, both from Department of Education in Science and Mathematics, NCERT, and me, Dr. Iram Khan from CIET NCERT, will be interacting with you throughout this course. Wish you best of luck. Happy learning. Thank you.